Hydroxylectomy. So what is a hydroxylectomy and what is a hydroxyl? Well, hydroxylectomy is removal of the hydroxyl, but if you don't know what a hydroxyl is, then you don't know what a hydroxylectomy is. And if you do, then you do, then I guess it's really about a hydroxyl. So what is a hydroxyl? A hydroxyl is basically an accumulation of water or liquid inside the scrotum. It's not really inside the scrotum, it's actually right next to the testicle. So the testicle, a little bit of like embryology, comes down to the scrotum from the back of the body. So the gonads, which are basically a bunch of tissue that forms in the embryo that eventually makes it down after becoming a testicle all the way down into the scrotum, comes from the back of the body, right where the kidneys are. So that's why testicular pain, okay, you can feel it in your belly, because the nerves that supply the testicle are actually same as the nerves that supply the kidney and the inside of the body. So on their way down to the scrotum, they took, okay, with them part of the lining of the inside of the body. And the inside of the body, okay, is called the lining is called peritoneum. Peritoneum basically is a layer, okay, of connective tissue that is mostly made to be able to slide. And the reason why is because the bowels are always sliding inside the body. If they weren't, they wouldn't be able to actually properly function and digest. So there in the peritoneum, there is a peritoneal fluid that sits almost like a lubricant. And when the testicles came down from the back of the body, they took part of this envelope with them and they brought it all the way to the scrotum. And then eventually, the envelope, if you think about it, like imagine it like this, and they take it with them. So now it comes through the outside, through from the inside, comes through the inguinal canal, and then part of it is just sitting right outside of the testicle. If there is a communication between that part of the envelope that's sitting right by the testicle and the inside of the body, well, fluid can easily come down from the inside of the body and then accumulate in the, you know, in that part right next to the testicle. And if it does, then this accumulation of the fluid is called a hydroxyl. Sometimes, even without communicating, it still makes a hydroxyl because the lining itself is almost programmed to be able to make some fluid itself. So that's a hydroxyl. And why would that be a problem? Well, it would be a problem if the hydroxyl became so big that it became very impractical. A man has a scrotum, it's not supposed to be super big. If it's super big, then you start sitting on it and it starts being quite painful and it becomes almost debilitating because, you know, even if you're just walking, this thing hanging, you know, you can just squish it and it can be very painful. So if you're squishing your scrotum because it's becoming so big, then we can fix it. We can remove the hydroxyl and now you don't have to worry about having a scrotum that's too big. If you find yourself lifting your scrotum to sit down, that's also an indication that your scrotum is getting way too big. And if it gets too big, you can hurt it, you can sit on your testicle. So instead of doing that, we can just remove that bag of water and then you can be, you know, you can sit comfortably without having to worry about your scrotum. So that's what a hydroxyl is, and that's how we do a hydroxylectomy.